morning everybody, today is Thursday, October 1st, 7:30 a.m. 7:30 a.m. Eastern Time. Let's start this morning call with a quick disclaimer. I only express my studies, I'm not a financial advisor. Future stocks, cryptocurrency and options trade involve substantial risk of loss and is not suitable for every investor. The valuation of future stocks with cryptocurrency and options may fluctuate, and as a result, especially if you are leveraged, investors may lose more than their original investments. So let's start this morning call if this quick, possible zigzag that are posted in the closed group and consequently put in the market structure document. As I put as a target the possibility of this uptrend finish that started September, finish around 5,825, 5,850, or a little bit above. Because I start to see puts in the money being bought, getting in dominance in higher levels. If you could you be also a squeeze setup, I don't disregard. Okay? But usually when you start to see puts being bought, in the money, higher levels, getting dominance compared with the call. And especially when the put call rate is very low, market is running without hedge, is a setup for a possibility, intermediate top. And I'm not saying that XPX will top over here, market will crash and that's it. Not like that. So, what I'm saying, that's a possible pullback for a new rally. Maybe. I cannot guarantee a new rally because we don't have flow yet. Of course, the current flow is still supportive to more upside. And consequently, since puts have been bought, as I highlighted over here, we could see XPX going up to 5,800. Let's use XX, but you could go up to 5,800. If you break up, especially the region that started at 5,825 and going up to 5,850, the tendency is to go up to 6K. Why I'm telling 6K? Because they start to generate gamma delta exposure at 6K. Look this big blue bar. Right, this big blue bar opening interest in 6K, this is really high. It's really high. And why I put 5,200, 5,250 as a maximum downside target is because this is where maximum pain is located. Calls and puts, are at the almost same level. Okay. So this tends to be a major support. Okay? Anyway, we talk about like 10% pullback. And if you come and see the graph pattern, for example, SP 500 after a big melt up is giving us a 10% pullback. So it's totally reasonable to see a zigzag as I post here. As the flow suggests, we could go up to 5,825, 5,250. And then a pullback up to 5,250 is totally normal. Also, follow the current pattern. Big melt up. 10% pullback. Big melt up. 10% pullback. Pay attention that now this melt up, I have been also posted to you guys some fractals, especially 1929. The fractal that starts in 1928 and go up to 1932, right? The last melt up. Break the previous all-time high and starting August 1929 and ends in September 1929. And after we saw a crash, I'm not telling that this will repeat, right? I cannot guarantee this because fractal is just another tool that you can use for a graphing analysis, as you guys have Elliott wave and etc. Right? If we really mirror 1929, we have been doing the same movement that you saw back in 1929. It's almost like 90 degree melt up, right? This one is almost 90 degree. If you put it, for example, in a monthly or weekly, this is 90 degree, right? Exactly 90 degree. Much, the angle is much higher compared over here. Is a little bit below 90 degree, but this one is 90 degree exactly. I'm not telling that the market will crash. I don't know. I cannot measure this. I cannot guarantee this. No, that's impossible to me. I can give you guys a clue regarding the flow. As I told you guys yesterday, and I highlighted very well in the market structure document. We could see a black Monday. Yes, we could because of lack of support. But we also could see a big spike at the close because the amount of gamma in opening interest at 5,750, and we saw a big melt up at the close, right? I give you guys, exactly the big picture how the book was. I cannot predict a black swan. I cannot predict a crash, as internet gurus do. I can't. I can show you guys, weakness and strength. If a black swan arise, is another point. But I'm not the person that you tell you guys that a black swan you are arise. I'm the person that look the flow and tell you where market could you go, where you could you see weakness, how much could you be, the pullback and etc. Okay, analyze the option book, especially XPX. A lot of people have been asking me about, assets in general, SPY. And I tell people I'm not expert in those assets, and that it's very difficult to measure movements, analyze SPY, analyze Apple, because asset means asset. XPX is pure cash, is money, is money. When you have an asset, you sell calls. Maybe you are really want to sell those calls at the level that the strike that you sold the call. And then if you sell a call and buy put, maybe you want to sell in that asset and also buy protection if you go below, the another strike. So we have a minimum way to make interpretation of the orders that you guys monitor. So for me, it doesn't make any sense, to monitor flow, not flow, but option book from assets, because assets are assets. We cannot measure what is behind the order, right? XPX is pure flow. XPX is cash. Okay? XPX is cash, is not an asset. We cannot have an asset, to cover what you are buying or what you are selling. You buy or selling cash. Okay? So the orders that I monitor basically is flow, because it's money flow, is getting in or getting out from the market. Okay? Hope you guys understand. I'm not expert in assets at all. And also nobody it is, because every order that you guys saw in the book have a asset being covered. So we don't know what the dealers have been doing. But Fabio, the AMC, blah blah blah, squeeze back in 2020 was able to catch through the unusual areas, but it is not, because maybe if somebody sold, we don't know, right? After the fact is easy. You guys have been seeing that all those tools only come public after the fact, not before the fact. I never see the owners of those tools telling me, saying, oh, I saw a big orders in Microsoft, I'm mirroring those orders. I never saw that. I always saw those guys after the fact came, oh, I was able to capture these to my tool. Okay? It's because assets is very difficult to measure what the person behind the orders have been doing. Okay? So if you mirror those orders and get, screwed, it's your fault. Of course, if you get profitable, it's also is lucky. As I said, we don't know what's going on behind those structures. As you guys know, I only follow XPX, because XPX is cash. Is cash. Okay? Consequently, I'm try to define tops, resistance, support through the cash index. So I post this zigzag with a possibility. Let me repeat what I have been saying. A possibility to go up to 5800 XX because you know puts start to being bought in those levels, special expiration December 31, right? Also notice that JP Morgan XPX fund is a cash fund. Also, you know, roll over the collar and puts, you know, and bring at least, you know, the opening status in higher strikes. Now 6020. Consequently, I highlighted over here. If you break the region that started 5830 and go up to 5850, the tendencies go to up to 6K. We could see, of course, a break during the intraday and close below. The important, you know, is to not start to not close above those range, okay? If you start to close above the range, the tendencies go up to 6K, especially because they start to generate gamma a lot in the higher opening status at 6K, expiration December 31, okay? But this is what I'm looking for. Doesn't mean that this will going to happen. This is my interpretation of the book that we have up to December 31. Okay? So regarding today, so let's compare what they left in the book yesterday and what we have in the book right now. The gamma basically is the same. It wasn't updated as I was thought that supposed to be updated, but didn't, so still the same. 5,750 is the magneto, is where located the GEX. So, since the magneto is below from where we closed, we could see a backtest at 5,750. I don't expect a break at 5,750. Okay? Worst case scenario, I tend to be 5,725. 5,725 also is the inflection point to flow. Flip from bullish to bearish. Remember, not gamma flip. I'm talking about flow flip. Flow is different than gamma. Okay? So the flow tend to be flip to be bearish as soon as you start to close below 5,725 and 5,725 start to act as a resistance. Okay? Anyway, for today. Pay attention that what they left yesterday, we saw weakness below 5,725. Also highlighted over here, 5,725 is the inflection point for the downsides, right? And we have been seeing DEX and JAX yesterday located at 5,750. So I don't really expect, you know, a breakdown at 5,750. We could back test 5,750 and buy supposed to be jumping, especially because we are in a positive gamma environment. What the positive gamma environment means? Dips will be absorbed, rallies will be sold. Okay? Per current DEX design, pay attention that the DEX, the delta exposure move in pre-market from 5,750, right? Now look how 5,750 is to 5,770. So if we backtest 5,750 buyers jump in, don't get scared if markets melt up and do another all-time high and backtest 5,770. So the inflection point for the upside now, the major resistance intraday will be 5,770. But pay attention in the VANA, in the Vega, not in the VANA, in the Vega, that Vega suggests us a volatility at the open. A possibility to see volatility at the open. If you see volatility at the open, VANA tend to generate a sell pressure flow. And we could see another dump and pump? Yes, we could. We could see a bullish charm at the close. Okay? But the importance at the level. 5,750 tend to be the support. 5,725 inflection point for the downsides. Could be the worst case scenario. Tend to be the worst case scenario. And 5,770 could be the major resistance and maximum upside target. Okay? And maximum upside target. pay attention, something that I want to highlight to you guys, is the dark pool index. The dark pool index since last week start to drop, and now print at 45%. Still in a bullish level, but came from 52-53% up to 45%. So September, you know, all the internet gurus, all those, you know, internet statistic guys that, you know, show us on our spreadsheet, 99% of the time September is bearish, and then you see a recover 99% of the time in an election period, you see a red September, and then end of the year rally. So everybody's messing up, right? All those internet fools messing up, because, you know, September was our outperformance, you know, month, closing all-time highs. And market through dark pool had plenty of liquidity. Now liquidity have been removing in the book. So something that I also highlight to you guys in the closed group is the buyback, is the buyback blockout period. So why you guys saw a huge dark pool index above 50% during September, and now at the end of the September, the dark pool index start to drop more than 5% and now print 45% because the blackout period. So who bought in September? Corporations. Corporation bought heavily their own assets. I also put over here in the closed group, you know, the S&P 500 sector announced buybacks last 3 months. We closed the quarter period yesterday. Now we start a new quarter. Now we enter back in a blackout period. If you start to see the dark pool index is going down, it's because CTAs, hedge funds, are not willing to buy. So the door is getting tighter, right? It's not wide open as September, a plane of liquidity, 50% and above for the entire month. So the blackout, the buybacks blackout period is important, especially when you start to measure the dark pool index and start to see drop, huge drop, as soon we are closed from the buyback blackout period. Something could you be happening in this period? Yes. We could you see volatility? Yes. I also highlighted the summary. If you're not highlighting the summary, I could you be highlighted in the closed group. Let me get the market here. I highlighted the market structure document. So from now on, I expect dealers to be long vol and short gamma and delta. Doesn't mean that the uptrend will not continue. I forget the word not. Okay? But from now on, what the setup suggests to me is that dealers start to be long in vol and short in gamma and delta. Consequently, we could see a reversal in trend. And consequently, reversal in flow as well. Could be start. I'm not telling that you will start today, tomorrow, Friday, but some point this month, right? Consequently, I already post you guys this possible zigzag. I don't know the dates. I'm just telling targets based in the option book, the SPX option book, especially where we start to see puts in dominance in higher levels, right? In higher levels. Okay? Since I already covered basically everything, let's just review the levels for today. 5,750 major support, worst case scenario 5,725, as I highlighted during this morning call video. As soon as you break down 5,725, if 5,725 start to be the resistance, is because flow you flip to be bearish. Okay? Above 5,750, if you see at the open some volatility, as Vega suggests, a possibility to see a bearish vana, a dump and pump could be the setup again for today, especially if you hold above 5,750. If you hold above 5,750 bias jump in, we could see market trading up to 5,770. That's the level that I expected yesterday, remember? So we could see printing today. 5,770 is where DEX is located, tend to be the rejection. Okay, 5,770 tend to be the rejection. Then, if we break, so we need to look for 5,770 as an inflection point of the upside. As I put in the market structure document, because the structure left yesterday, if you break 5,770, we could go up to 5,795. Okay? So levels 5,750 support, worst case scenario 5,725. Regarding upside, rejection tend to be 5,770. Break up 5,770, maximum upside target 5,795. Okay? Guys, take care, enjoy your day, don't go against the flow. The agenda today is kind of busy. Start, you know, after the market open, especially if ISM, JOLTS, job opening, and you have some FONC members speaking at 11 a.m., 11:10. Okay? But the majority of the FONC speakers start, not the major, yeah, the majority start at after the closing bell at 6:15 p.m. Eastern Time. So the agenda today is not so calm, is really busy, especially and also especially because it start after the open. Okay? Start at 9:45 with Standard & Poor's Global US Manufacturing and then ISM and the jobs, the JOLTS at 10 a.m. Guys, take care, follow the flow, follow the levels, pay attention to the levels, write down the levels and respect the levels. Okay? Talk to you guys soon. Take care.